Now, if you hear, looks like a good audience. Sounds like a good audience. I don't know. It's hard to see very well. Maybe that's fine. You know, sounds good, so that's the main thing. That was a classic jazz tune called Bag's Groove. And I wanted to mention that I messed up the interior portions of the program for this band. It's actually St. Thomas Second, and then Blue Skies. So if you know Blue Skies, you won't be disappointed. And you won't think it's some weird new abstract jazz arrangement of said tune. It's really a whole different tune. So St. Thomas and then Blue Skies. And then Sidewinder is correctly listed fourth. So yeah, please hang around for the Jazz Ensemble part. After all, we'll have a brief break between bands. But the other thing I want to mention is this. You notice like everything's arranged by Mark Taylor, which I kind of forgot about until I did the program. But it's because this is a slightly smaller version of a big band. It's in fact marketed as a little big band. It's kind of a really nice sized group. It's slightly reduced numbers, but mighty in spirit. So anyway, so that's why they're all Mark Taylor arrangements. But a lot of great classic jazz tunes. So this one is going to be, again, St. Thomas. Not Blue Sky, St. Thomas.
Thank you.
1930s jazz composition. Fletcher Henderson was a really important early big band arranger. Ultimately ended up selling a lot of his big band book to the Benny Goodman Orchestra and doing arrangements for Benny Goodman. And there is actually, this is, I think this is the version we have, is the Benny Goodman recording. There's a couple recordings that are real similar. It's very short, because it fit everything on one side. They didn't even have LPs at the time. They had the little 33 records, and so everything's like about 3 minutes. So even the Duke Ellington compositions, which all that stuff, it'd be packed in. So a lot going on in a short amount of time. Anyway, speaking of Duke Ellington, this next piece is a Duke Ellington piece, and we're gonna have some brass friends come up. They're staying right about where I am, so they'd like me to leave now. So I guess I'll do that. So this is Such Sweet Thunder. Thank you. If you remember what I said about the first two, there's a lot packed into 3 minutes. With that arrangement, there's a lot packed into like three times as long. There's a lot of stuff in that arrangement. Michael Mossman likes to keep the band occupied, I think, with his arrangements. They're very good, though. Okay, so we have a lot of classic jazz tunes. If you are a jazz listener, you probably have recognized like most all of these that we've done, or at least especially the lab band, like that one that's real standard. Anyway, so we have one more. This one's an original by a drummer, Jeff Hamilton, great jazz drummer, plays in the Clayton Hamilton Jazz Orchestra, co-led with John and Jeff Clayton. John Clayton's the arranger of this tune, so they're really great. Big band, we do a lot of John Clayton charts here. They're very nicely done. So this one is, it's kind of like a blues, but more extended blues form. So anyway, I won't bore you with the formal analysis, but it's kind of a long form too. So we'll feature a few solos. So thanks again for coming out. I know there's lots going on a Saturday night, but we appreciate you coming and taking the time to be here and share some music with us. So without any further ado, I think that's the last thing, right? I just like to check. Now I don't trust myself after the whole program debacle. I do that. Anyway, this is definitely Max, so this is the last tune for sure either way. So thanks again, and we will see you again hopefully this semester and later on.